Hi, I'm Katie.
And I'm Bryce, and this is our 2019 Ram ProMaster, which we converted ourselves, and it took us about 2 months to do.
This video is brought to you by Fantic. 2022 is here, and that means a whole new year of outdoor fun and adventure. And if you're gonna make the most of it, you need the right gear to ensure that you can enjoy it in comfort and safety. This 299-watt power station is a portable power generator with enough capacity and output ports to keep all of your devices fully charged wherever you go. It also works with solar panels for the ultimate off-the-grid experience, and with the USB-C 60-watt fast charging for input and output, recharging takes no time at all. So click the link in the description and get a total of $90 off your Fantic Evo 300 power station by using code FLORB300 and clicking the link in the description below. And remember to subscribe.
When we were living downtown Chicago in like a 450 square foot apartment, Katie brought up that she thought it'd be cool to travel and live in basically like an RV. We didn't even like know about van life, and then we started looking into it.
Our lease for our apartment like happened to be up right at that time. So we just decided not to sign it, and we moved out and we were like, all right, let's do this.
Yeah, everything fell into place. We actually started out taping out the Ram ProMaster on the floor, and we're like, all right, this seems like it's gonna fit well. And then we started throwing it in PowerPoint. And then at that point, we're like, all right, I feel like we just need to start putting stuff together. And
I mean, plumbing the bathtub, we didn't know what we were doing.
Yeah, we didn't know how to plumb anything.
We didn't know what we were doing at all, basically.
We didn't know how to plumb. We didn't know how to do any electric. Luckily, my dad has an old neighbor who's a friend of his that knows how to do that stuff. And so he helped us a ton. Yeah. Didn't really have a budget. We decided in our minds that we wanted to stay under 15 grand, which we did by like $600. Including the price and the loan on the vehicle, we are at 48.49.
Yeah, I think that's right.
So this is our van. It is a 2019 Ram ProMaster, 159-inch wheelbase. Had the back of the van lifted. Obviously, we put a ton of weight into this thing, and so it just kind of made sense for us.
We also mounted our gray water tank under here and then put a little valve on it that we can just unscrew, and then I just pull this lever. That's been huge. We got the tank from Plastic Mart. I want to say it's the 9-gallon. It literally fits perfectly up in between two of the bars that like run across the van, so it could not have been a better fit.
We put on a 12.9 gallon propane tank in the back.
We only need to fill up once every month and a half, depending on how much we're running the heat, things like that.
We also put on a Wii Boost. If you're looking to have better signal or work full time on the road, I definitely think this is a necessity. If you have one bar, it'll give you two or three. If you have two bars, it'll basically give you three or four.
This is our garage. We have our charge controller, which is fed to by 600 watts of solar. We got those solar panels from Grape Solar. This is our inverter. It's a pure sine wave inverter, 3000 watts.
A couple months into van life, we added shore power. And so this is a charger that we're able to just plug in. The charger is a Samlex Power.
We have AGM deep cycle batteries, 620 amp hours of battery. This is a 33 gallon water tank.
I think we also got this from Plastic Mart.
We got two foldable kayaks.
These are tuk-tuk kayaks,
which takes up a ton of space, but we've got to kayak in some pretty incredible places. Put a little shoe holder. Our shoes were just flying all over the place, and it's been awesome for storage.
We got the propane fill, which obviously attaches to the propane tank. This is our water fill. Just have a key, open it up, and then put a hose in there and fill up our water tank in the garage.
This is the Girard tankless water heater. Specifically for RVs, we just got it off of Amazon. I think like 95% of the stuff that we got was off of Amazon.
This is our furnace exhaust. Also runs on propane. It's a Suburban furnace. Keeps the van extremely warm in the winter.
I honestly think that's pretty much it for the outside.
All right, let's go check out the inside. This seat's a swivel seat. We added the swivel seat after we bought the van. We also added these seat covers, the nice pockets in the back too, which works great for extra storage, which you could never have enough of. Up here, our laptops and stuff for working, as well as all of our pajamas, which we have a lot of. This is another curtain that we have that I also sewed. The middle layer of this curtain is fabric called Warm Window. It's like this super insulated fabric made for window curtains so that they're better insulated from the outdoors. So that works super well. So moving along, here we have our kitchen. So we have this live edge countertop, used Rubio Monocoat to cover the wood. And then we have this fridge. We love the kind of retro vibe it gives. The only downside being that it's not super efficient, so it does use a lot of our power. It has a separate freezer and refrigerator. So this is the freezer, which allows us to make ice, which is kind of amazing. We have this little ice cube tray that has a lid, which is super beneficial if you fill up the ice cube tray and then start driving. We have a stainless steel sink, goes down really deep and has like a grate at the bottom that the sink just came with. This faucet, which just goes straight to our fresh water tank. And this is our fresh drinking water tap. So that goes through our water drop water filter. Just has this nice little cover, and then it has three different filters that it runs through. The only downside is that when you replace the filter, you have to run the water for 5 minutes to flush the system. And so with a limited amount of water, it's kind of a bummer to just wait 5 minutes and watch your water fall down the drain. But a necessary evil, I think. And you don't have to replace them that often. It's kind of a different amount of time on each one. I think two of them are after a year mark, and then this PP one's every 6 months, so not too bad. This holds all of our pasta pots and pans, a couple of Tupperwares and cutting boards and a frying pan. Kind of all the essentials there. And then this is our oven. The company's Greystone. Usually whatever the directions say to like cook things at like 350 for like 10 minutes usually takes like twice as long than what it says, which I don't know if that's just kind of what happens when you're cooking with propane or what, but it works out and you kind of get the hang of it as things go on. I'd say rarely do we use all three burners at once, but it definitely has happened, like cooking our Thanksgiving dinner, you know, we had a lot going on. So it's nice to have more than one for sure. We did put in a real tile backsplash. We just used normal grout from Home Depot. We looked at using different flexible grouts, but we haven't had any problems with it. This is our pantry. Lots of tea, our coffee, and just whatever other snacks we're looking for. It's nice that they're on these hydraulic hinges, so these kind of just keep the cabinet open without you having to hold it open, which is really nice. This is where we keep all of our plates and cups and utensils. We have a lot of cooking utensils that we really don't use that much, so I guess that would be a recommendation. You probably need a lot less than you think you need. This is our Max Air fan. It's manual open, a lot cheaper than the one with the remote. It just has this little crank knob that you just twist to open it. Versus just clicking a button on a remote. We have a little seat here, and then this actually has some extra storage in it. Keep our hats and stuff in there, and the furnace is in there as well. And then we have, this is our table. So this slides out for us to eat. Brace can sit there, I can sit here. We did add a little latch to this. Sometimes it does slide open if we don't have the latch there to keep it closed when we're driving. And then this is our toilet. So we have a Nature's Head toilet. And it has this nice handy little tube that vents to the outside so any smell won't come into the van. The underbed storage we really can't access from the inside except through our laundry chute, really. But you can, like you can see the kayaks right there. So that's the kayaks coming from the back. But we really just use that for our laundry. We have this little laundry hamper here, so we just throw all of our dirty laundry in there. So this is actually our bathtub slash bench seat, so it has multiple purposes, which is awesome. This lid just pops off, and then we have our tub. We built this tub ourselves. It's all wood and epoxy. Put a lot of layers of epoxy on this thing. It drains straight to our gray water tank, and then it has this hose that we can use to shower. We had originally planned to put in a shower curtain around this, never got around to it, and then as we continued to use it, we realized we just really didn't need it. Both our bath and our sink are plumbed to the hot water heater, so we have hot water to do dishes, and we have hot water to take a shower. Part of the reason we chose the ProMaster is that you can fit a full-size bed sideways. This is just our full-size mattress from our apartment. And we have a down comforter to keep us extra warm. Lots of blankets, lots of pillows, and overall, it's a really comfy setup. Each have our own cabinet. That's Bryce's. This is mine. Clothes for all the seasons in here because we move around so much, and we like to be prepared for any situation we find ourselves in.
You can try to make a plan for executing something a certain way, but you just have to realize that like things aren't going to go to plan. a majority of the times, and you just have to be able to like adjust and kind of like go with the flow a little bit and like not let it completely get you down and just kind of take things as they come.
Yeah, I think one thing that I definitely learned is just that like being perfect is a little overrated. I've kind of been a perfectionist like my whole life, mm-hmm. and like I'm always trying to like tweak things to be just right. And I think I've definitely been able to kind of let that go a little bit. Take a deep breath and enjoy that things aren't always perfect and just kind of make the most of what you have. Your dad used to always say, like, whenever something new, like, didn't go quite right, you know, like, two pieces were supposed to match up, but they were like, like, a little, like, gap. You know, I was just like, it gives a character. And then I, like, at the beginning was very like, oh my gosh, no, we want this all to be perfect. And then, like, after a while, I was just loving it. I was like, anything that was like, you painted a little bit, gives a character, you move on. Yep. Now I love the little things in Iran that just have the character.
Makes
it more homey, I think. We went into it, I was like, we're gonna have a plan of like, these are all of the locations we're gonna go, this is where we're gonna stop, this is where we're gonna camp, like map out the whole United States. And we just didn't have time to do that. We just left, like slept at a gas station because we didn't know where we were going. And I don't know that I would 100% recommend that. Like get through your like first week of planned stops, but then, you know, just kind of go with the flow after that. Like you don't have to have everything planned out. You can just let the world take you where it's gonna go and enjoy it as you're going along.
Yeah.